breakfast in the lunchroom, we'll have a Monday chicken biscuit and mini pancakes, Tuesday breakfast pizza or French toast sticks, Wednesday cinnamon roll or cinnamon raisin biscuit, Thursday sausage biscuit or pancakes, Friday a donut or a Pop-Tart. For lunch this week, we'll be having a Monday quesadilla or cheese pizza, Tuesday chicken wings or hot pocket, Wednesday chicken tender sandwich or French bread pizza, Thursday spaghetti or pepperoni pizza, Friday chicken nuggets or cheese pizza. This week was Teacher Appreciation Week. Thank teachers for all that they do. There are only 14 days of school left. If you are interested in running for student council, pick up the forms in the office. The deadline is Tuesday, May 10th. The speeches and elections will be held on Friday, May 13th. Have a great week.
News. In softball, the area game started. The first game we won 7-3 versus Hamilton. In the second game we lost 6-4 to Danville. We beat Hamilton 4-3 in the elimination game and lost 6-3 in the finals. Finished second in the area, moving on to regionals. In girls track, they finished fourth in the section meet, set a 4x4 school record of 4:52, and Allie Temple qualified for state in javelin. In baseball, they got swept by North Jackson. The first game, they lost 6-0, and the second game, lost 4-1. Thank you. Have a great week.
Roar on. Do it for me. Now watch me whip. Kill it. Now watch me nae-nae. Okay. Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me nae-nae. Why me do
it? Now watch- the Alabama softball, they had a win 5-1 over South Carolina. Their next game will be against Georgia. Auburn had a loss to Tennessee 12-1. Their next game will be against Texas A&M. Bama lost 12-5 versus Mississippi State in baseball. Their next game will be against Auburn. In Auburn baseball, they had a loss to Kentucky 9-6. Their next game will be against Alabama. Tune in next week to see who will get whipped.
Good morning, afternoon, or good evening, everyone. I'm here with your local news. Guess what? The fair is coming back to town. The fair will be in its new location in front of the old Piggly Wiggly and across from Walmart. It will be open from the 11th to the 14th. The hours will be from 5 to 11 p.m. on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. There will be an afternoon performance on Saturday. This will begin at noon. That's all I have for you this week. Tune in next week for more of your around the town happenings.
Good morning, HS. I'm here with your weekly roar forecast. Lots of rain this week. Monday through Wednesday is calling for pure rain. Highs in the low 80s and lows in the mid 60s. Chance of rain, 80%. Thursday and Friday is calling for thunderstorms. Highs in the mid 80s and lows in the upper 60s. Chance of rain, 60%. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a fabulous week in your lives.
Hello and good morning, students, staff, and locals. As an update in the politics, with Trump as the only Republican candidate left in the presidential primary, he has become the presumptive nominee. This means he will be the official nominee when the Republican convention meets this summer. As Cruz and Kasich have both dropped out of the race since May 3rd primary results, on Democratic side, Sanders has vowed to stay in the race against Clinton until the very end, although the future looks clear that he will not be the party's nominee. The presidential campaign ahead will be hard to predict and hard-fought and definitely not boring. Remember, you have a voice to make a choice. Have a great week.
Elephants have been a show business attraction in the United States for more than 200 years. But elephants performed their last show for the Ringling Bros and Barnum and Bailey Circus on May 1st. For years, animal rights activists have been calling for the circus to stop using elephants in its shows. This is a very emotional time for us, Ringmaster Jonathan Lee Iverson announced at the end of the show in Rhode Island, describing the 6 Asian elephants as beloved members of the circus family. Iverson thanked the animals for their performances over the decades. "Thank you so much for many years of joys," he told them as they left the ring for the last time. During the performance, the elephants danced, balanced on each other's backs, sat on their hind legs, and pretended to sleep. That's all I have this week, but tune in next week for more World News.
This has been your Weekly Roar.